Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Hope you all fine. This lecture is for grade 9, subject chemistry, chapter number 8. This is my 29th video lecture, and I am your lecturer, Mrs. Saira Jamal. Dear students, today I'm going to talk about the comparison of alkali and alkaline earth metals. The first comparison is position in the periodic table. Group 1A elements of the periodic table except hydrogen are known as alkali metals, because hydrogen is a non-metal, it is not a metal, but due to similarity in electronic configuration, hydrogen has been assigned a place in group number 1. So group number 1, other elements except hydrogen are known as alkali metals. Why are they called alkali metals? They are called alkali metals because they form alkaline solution or basic solution or hydroxides when they react with water. So due to this property, as when they react with water, they give or they produce a basic solution, an alkaline solution, or they form hydroxides, are called alkaline or are called alkali metals. While group 2A elements are called alkaline earth metals. Why are they called alkaline earth metal? Alkaline, same like alkali metal, that they form alkaline solution or hydroxide when they react with water. But why are they called earth metals? They are called earth metals because they are abundantly present on earth crust. Alkaline earth metal, alkaline means same like alkali metals. They also form a basic solution or alkaline solution or hydroxide when they react with water. But why are they called earth metals? The reason is that they are abundantly present on earth crust. We have one of the example of alkali metal. You can see the oxide of alkali metal, that is sodium oxide. When react with water, it will give sodium hydroxide. So you can see that the oxides of these metals, if it is alkali metal or alkaline earth metal, when they react with water, they form basic solution or they form alkaline solution or they form hydroxide. You can see sodium hydroxide is a strong base. Second property or comparison is general electronic configuration of alkali metal and alkaline earth metal. The general electronic configuration of alkali metals are NS1. NS1, it means that all the alkali metals, they have one electron in their outermost shell, and that subshell is S subshell. That's why they are called S block element, because their outermost electron is present in S subshell. Alkaline earth metal, their general electronic configuration is NS2. It means they also have two electrons in the S subshell. So they are called, they are also called S block element. Alkali metals and alkaline earth metals, or group number 1A and group number 2A of the periodic table, are called S block elements. Elements present in alkali metals and alkaline earth metals. In alkali metals, the elements are lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, and francium. While the elements present in alkaline earth metals are beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, and radium. The fourth comparison is between their ionization energy. What is ionization energy? The minimum amount of energy required to remove an electron from the outermost shell of an isolated gaseous atom is called ionization energy. So how can we measure ionization energy, or what is the unit of ionization energy? It is kilojoule per mole. Kilojoule per mole is the unit of ionization energy. Alkali metals have low ionization energies. Why they have low ionization energies? due to their large size and can easily lose electrons to form cations. So due to their large size, the alkali metals can easily, or less amount of energy is required to remove an electron from the outermost shell of alkali metal. That's why we can say that their ionization energies are low. Alkali metals are so reactive that they are never found in free state. They always form compounds because they are highly reactive. Their reactivity increases down the road. Now, very important point, the reactivity of metal increases from top to bottom along the group, and the reactivity of metal decreases from left to right along the period. For example, sodium is more reactive than potassium. Sodium and potassium belongs to the same group, that is the alkali metals, but sodium is present in period number 2 and potassium in period number sodium is present in period number 3 and potassium is present in period number 4. So it means that we are going down the group. So that's what you can say, that going down the group, the reactivity increases. The reactivity increases down the group. So potassium is more reactive than sodium because potassium comes after sodium. Okay, sorry. Potassium is more reactive than sodium. Then alkaline earth metals. Alkaline earth metals, ionization energy of alkaline earth metal. Alkaline earth metal also have low ionization energy, but their ionization energy is higher than alkali metals. They also have great tendency to lose both the electrons to form dipositive cation. Two electrons are present in the outermost shell of alkaline earth metal, so they can lose those two electrons easily to form dipositive cation, like +2 ion. But I told you that the ionization energy of alkaline earth metals are higher than alkali metals, but they are less reactive than alkali metals. These metals also show increased reactivity down the group. I told you reactivity increases down the group and decreases from left to right. Fifth comparison is about their hardness. Alkali metals are really soft and they can be cut with a sharp knife, and alkaline earth metals are harder than the alkali metals. Alkali metals are softer and we can even cut alkali metals with a knife. For example, sodium metal, which we use in lab for practicals. So sodium metal, like if we think about metal, the first thing which comes in our mind is that metals are very hard and we cannot cut them with knife. But alkali metals are soft. An example is sodium metal. Sodium metal, we can cut it with a sharp knife. The comparison between alkali and alkaline earth metals, you can also write in the tabular form. I have a table. You can see the first, these green columns are for alkali metal and the purple are for alkaline earth metals. The term alkali is used to name the group 1A elements of the periodic table. Group 1A elements of the periodic table are called alkali metals, while the term alkaline is used to name group 2A elements of the periodic table. That is, the first one is about their position in the periodic table. Second one is about their hardness. Alkali metals are soft, while alkaline earth metals are hard. The third property is about their valence shell electronic configuration. So alkali metals, I told you, have one valence electron, while alkaline earth metals have two valence electrons. Alkali metal loses that one electron from their outermost shell and will form monopositive cation. This is called +1 cation, also called monopositive cation. While alkaline earth metals have two electrons in the outermost shell, so they can make divalent cation. The next property is about the ionization energy. So alkali metals have a lower ionization energy, while alkaline earth metals have higher ionization energy than alkali metals. So these comparison you can also write in tabular form. Some important alkali and alkaline earth metals. So the most important alkali metal is sodium. We know that iron is the most commonly used metal. It is hard and strong. So when the term metal comes in our mind, we think it will be as hard as iron. But for sodium, sodium is a soft metal and it can be cut with a knife. Its melting point is 97.8 and boiling point is 881.4 degrees Celsius. The reason is that in iron, metal atoms are tightly packed due to small size, and due to that tightly packing, they have very strong metallic bonds due to many electrons involved in the bond formation. If many electrons are involved in bond formation, definitely the bond will be strong. But for sodium, only one electron is present in the outermost shell, and that only one electron is involved in bond formation. That's why that bond will be weaker as compared to iron. And sodium is bigger atom. First thing, it is bigger atom. Second is only one electron is involved in bond formation. So that's why it has weaker metallic bond, and which make it soft and we can cut it with a knife. Iron has close packing, first thing, small size, second, third, many electrons are involved in bond formation and hence have strong metallic bond. But in case of sodium, the sodium atom is bigger in size and only one electron is bond formation. So the metallic bond will be weaker and which will make sodium a soft metal. And that's why we can cut it with a knife. The reaction of sodium, or in other words, we can say alkali metals are highly reactive. And one of the example of their high reactivity is the reaction of sodium with water. Sodium metal, when react with water, it is a highly exothermic reaction. And when mistakenly a drop of water fall on sodium metal, a small or a light explosion takes place, and that explosion is harmful. If God forbid it touch our skin or touch our face, it may damage our face and the skin. So like the practicals where we are using the sodium metal, that needs special care because the reaction is highly exothermic, and it completed with a light explosion if a water droplet falls on sodium metal. Why that explosion takes place? Because the sodium injected water will give, will produce hydrogen gas, and that hydrogen gas production is very speedy reaction or very high reaction along with the release of energy or release of heat. For this reason, sodium should not be picked with fingers, that even the water or the sweat of our fingers, if they come in contact with sodium, may cause a light explosion as well. So it is recommended that don't pick sodium with fingers. Always use spatula or forceps for picking up the sodium. Now, in a limited supply of oxygen, sodium form sodium oxide, and in excess of oxygen, sodium will form peroxide. If little oxygen is there, it will form sodium oxide. If more oxygen is there, it will form peroxide. Sodium, when mixed with potassium, it forms a liquid alloy, and that alloy is used as a coolant in a nuclear reactor. This is the first use. The second use is sodium is used in sodium lamps to illuminate highways, like at the roadside. The lamps which are used, they contain sodium metal. Petroleum industries also use sodium in production of anti-knockout compound for gasoline, which prevent the engine from spoiling. the gasoline used is mixed with sodium, and that sodium mixed gasoline actually is used as an anti-knocking agent. Anti-knocking agent means which prevent the engine from spoiling. Magnesium and calcium are the most after sodium. Sodium and then potassium and sodium. The next one is magnesium and calcium. Magnesium and calcium are actually the alkaline earth metals, and they are the most common alkaline earth metals. Metallic bonding is present in all metals, but they involve two electrons. In metallic bonding, because two electrons are present in the outermost shell, therefore these metals are soft but are harder than alkali metals. They are relatively reactive but less reactive than alkali metal. Magnesium react with steam, but calcium react with cold water. It means, as I told you, the QT increases when we go down the group. So calcium comes after magnesium. That's why calcium is more reactive. Even at cold, with cold water, it will react and will give us product. But magnesium is less reactive. It will react only with steam or with hot water to form magnesium oxide and hydrogen gas. Calcium, I told you, is highly reactive, so it will react with cold water and will form calcium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Magnesium reacts with oxygen at high temperature, while calcium reacts with oxygen even at room temperature. So these two reactions, reaction with water and reaction with oxygen, shows that that the reactivity of calcium is greater than reactivity of magnesium. And this also confirms the statement that the reactivity of metal increases from top to bottom along the group. Magnesium has a relatively low density. It is lighter in weight, and it is used in making lightweight alloy with aluminum. Aluminum is also the lightest metal. So aluminum and magnesium, they are mixed together and used for making the bodies of automobiles, bodies of aircraft, spaceships, cameras, etc., because they are lighter in weight and they are highly stable. Since magnesium burns brilliantly, it is used in photo flash guns, and magnesium hydroxide, which is also called milk of magnesia, it is commonly used as anti-acid, like to reduce acidity of stomach. We are using this suspension of magnesium hydroxide. Calcium is also an important component of teeth and bones. You know, calcium is present in teeth and in bones, and calcium ions are found in all living cells, so they are involved in clotting of blood. The blood clotting also need calcium ions, and a proper calcium and potassium ion balance is required even for normal heart function. You have heard about that we have a special electrolytes balance in our body, and all those ions must be present in a required proportion so that all our body parts will function properly. If the balance, if this ions balance or electrolytes imbalance takes place in the body, so that may be also a cause of many problems of our body. Then next topic is about the inertness of noble metals. Inertness of noble metals means that the noble metals, they are least reactive. First of all, noble metals are those metals which are least reactive. They does not react with other substances. The reason is their outermost shells are completely satisfied, so they don't need to react with other substances. The chemistry of metal is characterized by their ability to lose electron to form cation. One more thing is that please don't confuse noble metal with noble gases. Most of the students, they make mistake in by mixing the noble metals with noble gases. Noble gases are group 8A elements of the periodic table. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, they are noble gases. But the topic which I am discussing, it is about the noble metals. Like all the metals, they are highly reactive, except some of the metals which are inert. Inert means they does not react with other substances. And I told you the reason that their outermost shells are already completely stabilized or satisfied. So they does not need to react with other substances. So those metals are called noble metals. Noble metals and noble gases are totally different. The chemistry of metals is characterized by their ability to lose electrons to form cations. Some metals such as copper, silver, gold, and platinum are relatively difficult to oxidize. Difficult to oxidize means they are least reactive towards even oxidizing agent. Therefore, these metals are often called noble metals. Gold and platinum exist mostly as free elements in nature. As they are least reactive, so they can exist independently in nature or free in nature without making compound. I told you in the previous for the previous slides that metals are highly reactive and they does not exist in free state. The reason is that they are highly reactive, so they react with other substances and form compounds. But the noble metals, they are highly stable, so they does not need to make compound, and that's why they exist free in nature. Copper and silver exist in both free and combined state. And out of these noble metal, the gold and platinum, they exist mostly in free state, but some of the compounds of copper and silver exist. All active metals react with HCl. Active metals mean the reactive metals, not the noble metals. Noble metals are inert, they are inactive. But active metals, which are highly reactive, so all the reactive metals, they react with HCl, which is a strong acid. But noble metals, they do not react with HCl. And copper and silver react with strong oxidizing agents such as concentrated nitric acid and concentrated hypochlorite acid. But gold and platinum, they does not react. Now, gold and platinum react only with mixture of solution. That mixture of solution is called aqua regia. Gold and platinum react only with aqua regia. What is aqua regia? Aqua regia is a mixture of three parts by volume of concentrated hydrochloric acid and one part by volume of concentrated nitric acid. It means that aqua regia is actually a mixture of two strong acids, hydrochloric acid and nitric acid. So the percentages are different. Hydrochloric acid will be three times that of the nitric acid. Three parts by volume hydrochloric acid and only one part by volume of concentrated nitric acid. So the ratio is 3:1. Importance of silver and gold. Where we use silver and gold? Silver and gold have been admired for thousands of years and are still used in jewelry and fine flatware and ornaments. These metals have beautiful luster. Luster means shine and high malleability. Malleability, we can make designs of it. Lots of designs of silver jewelry and like the gold. Therefore, they can be transformed easily into different shapes. However, both are too soft to be used for these purposes. We cannot use pure gold or pure silver for making jewelries of it or for making other ornaments of it. We have to mix copper in it because copper will make these gold and silver a bit harder, and then we can make designs of it. That's why we cannot use the 24 karat gold for making jewelry or designs of it. Mostly we are using 22 karat gold for making nice and fine designs of gold. The reason is copper actually when mixed, we mix with gold, will make the gold a bit harder, and that gold will be able to make design of it. Now that is called alloy, because mixing of two or more metals, the mixture is called alloy. In former times, gold and silver were used in coins, but nowadays, copper nickel alloys are used for making coins. Which alloy is used for making coins nowadays? Nickel and copper. Copper nickel alloys are used for making coins. Silver is an excellent conductor of both electricity and heat, so it is used for making utensils. You might have had the painful experience of using a silver spoon to take soup. When you dip silver spoon in a hot soup, the spoon will also get heated, and then when you put that spoon in mouth, it will burn your mouth. That's why the reason is that silver is a very good conductor of heat and electricity. The light sensitive silver halide. Silver halides are very sensitive to light. If you keep silver halide in open air, then what will happen? The silver color will tarnish into black color, or the silver article will tarnish into black color. Jewelry, the jewelry turns black actually. The reason is that silver halides are very sensitive towards light, and they are used in photographic processes, in photographic reels. Gold alloys are extensively used in dentistry. They are inert, that's why they use the gold in dentistry also. Some compounds of gold have useful therapeutic application, even in medicines for the arthritis, we are using gold compounds. Salts of gold are used for treatment rheumatoid arthritis, that is a joint diseases of joints. We are using salts of gold for the treatment of those problems. And the next one is electronegative character. The tendency of atom to gain electron. Electronegative character is actually opposite of electropositive character. Electropositive character is a loss of electron to form cation, and electronegative character is gain of electrons to form anion. Is called electronegative character. Electropositive character is of metal. Metal loses electrons and form cation. Electronegative character is of the non-metals. Non-metal actually they gain electrons and form anion. And these non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. Metallic oxides are basic in nature, and non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. Platinum, I told you, is widely used as a catalyst for many industrial processes. Platinum is a metal, noble metal, and we use it for industrial processes. 100% sulfuric acid is prepared by a process called contact process, and in that process we use platinum as a catalyst. And in automobile engine we are using a catalytic converter that control the pollution and make the air pollution free, and all the harmful gases which are produced in the automobile engine, they are converted into non-harmful gases by using that catalytic converter in our automobile engine. So this converter also contain a catalyst that is platinum in it. And a platinum compound also called cisplatin is used as an anti-cancer agent for the reducing the cancer problems. Then we have society, technology and science. As I told you that the gold, mostly we are using 24 karat gold, but 24 karat gold is very soft. We cannot make designs of it, so we are using 22 karat gold. Karat is actually the unit of gold. So how much percent of gold is present in 22 karat gold? To find out the percentage, we have this formula: 22 divided by 24 multiplied by 100. We will get 92%. It means that 22 karat gold contain 92% gold and 8% copper in it. That is called 92% gold. Copper is a common coinage metal, though modern pennies are only copper plated. In Pakistan, coins are nowadays made from copper nickel alloy. Non-metals, as I told you, what are non-metals? Non-metals have high ionization energy. They have high electronegativities. They have poor thermal conductor, and they are bad conductor of heat and electricity. They are not malleable and ductile. They are brittle, means when you transform it into any shape, they breaks up. So we cannot turn them into any design or shape. They are little or no metallic luster. They have no shine or very little shine. They gain electron easily. They are dull. No, they have no shining. They are dull, not metallic shiny. Although they may be colorful, they have some color, but they are bad conductor. They have no shine. Electronegative character, as I told you, electronegativity is the gain of electron to form ions. So electronegative character along the period. Electronegative character increases from left to right along the period. Electropositive character decreases from left to right, and electronegative character is the reverse of electropositive character. So electropositive character increases from left to right. This is due to increased nuclear charge, means small size, so greater charge, which bind electrons more tightly to the nucleus. And along the group, as electropositive character increases from top to bottom, so electronegative character is the reverse. Electronegative character decreases from top to bottom along the group. This is due to decreased nuclear charge and increase atomic size. So this was all about the metals, non-metal, their electropositive character, their electronegative characters, and about the noble metals, about the importance of noble metals, where we use them, all we discussed in this lecture. I hope you will understand this lecture. Inshallah, the next topic we will do in next lecture. Till then, take care. Allah.